about pet waste. And today we're at the Mount Highland location of Total Bonds Veterinary Clinics with Dr. Kim Langholz. And like I said, we're going to talk about pet waste. We know in the environment it's a bad thing. All that bacteria that's left behind in that pet waste gets washed away when it rains. It gets washed into storm drains or directly into our creeks, and then we see high bacterial loads. But today, really, we're here at the vet clinic. We want to know, how can pet waste that's left behind impact our pets?
The big concerns, I think, for me, as it relates to not only pet health but human health, would be the roundworms and the hookworms. It's really kind of disgusting when you think that a single female roundworm can lay 100,000 eggs a day. So if you had a puppy with, say, 4 or 5 females in there, you're getting 500,000 eggs in your yard or in the park every day. But our pets and we are walking through them, potentially picking up these parasite eggs and ingesting them or eating them. And they can cause significant health problems for our pets and for people. In children, the larva, the parasite, can migrate through the body and go up into a child's eye and cause blindness. And if it goes to the brain, it can cause neurologic problems. In our pets, all of those parasites can cause anemia. They don't get the nutrients that they need from their food because the parasites are stealing it. If they have enough of those parasites in their intestinal tract, it can cause a blockage and death in our pets.
How do you prevent all this?
When a dog or even a cat defecates or poops in the environment, it's going to potentially lead to that contamination. So pick it up right away before those eggs have a chance to get down in the soil.
Wow, so we really learned here today that pet waste is not just a nuisance, not just an eyesore, but it can actually be very harmful to us and our families, our children, and our pets. And just thanks for all that information.
You're very welcome. Scoop that poop.